success. We have two female game writers today. And before you guys say who you are, I told them earlier.
That you got all these pictures of men, because I think about when I was at Ubisoft, and I think 60% of the game writers.
They can hear you.
Super early, we're in pre-production, we call.
Stories with these kinds of characters. Hey, design, what kind of gameplay you want to do? And we're like, oh, well, maybe we shouldn't do the story if you want to do this kind of gameplay. And also, could you guys do this?
I'm supposed to be working on more than one project at a time. They use fully put.
It can be either good or bad. Like if you're stuck on something, it's good that you can swap gears, because then it refreshes and you go back to it and you're like, oh, it's a super easy solution. Why didn't I think about that earlier? But it can also be very hard if you just can't get your focus right. But in general, in AAA specifically, you tend to get on one project every time.
So it seems like in a lot of games, emergent storytelling can be just as important as scripted. What is the best way to balance those two, or design or emergent storytelling?
That is the question we always ask ourselves. look, the thing that we do when we do open world storytelling is we put tools in there, but half the time you have to acknowledge the players make their own stories, and that is fantastic. So you give them the playground to play in. Sometimes you give them directive lines, but you gotta let them go. You gotta cut them loose. I've played Skyrim. I never played the main story path. There's a main story path in Skyrim. What? I was like, no, I'm out there hunting a dragon, but the skeleton isn't following me everywhere. But, you know, it's part of emergent storytelling is the Lego blocks you give people, but you gotta let them build what they want with the Lego blocks. And that's a lot of work with design.
So can you talk a little bit about canon and how you make sure that you're staying consistent between either various different iterations of games, whether it's Assassin's Creed and any canon that exists in that, or
and so we can kind of work together to figure out like what part of the lore do you want to put in here? What do they have coming up? Because they're working on like comic books and recipe books and like whatever, all kinds of interesting stuff that they have going on. So they can feed me things that are coming up for them that I can then tie into the game because I know what the launch schedule is going to be like.
My main game writing expertise has been IP writing, so it's been coming to a large IP intellectual property that is already established, and for that. And I have found that being a fan of it when you come to it helps. And if you're not, just learn.
every year you sponsor Hackfort, which is, for those of you who are not aware, Hackfort. This is a tech festival that brings the community together to share knowledge and skills with one another.
Hackfort.